Welcome to Charles Sturt University, and in particular, the University Farm. My name's James Stevens. I'm the farm manager here at Charles Sturt University. And I'd like to welcome you to this 360 degree view of the University Farm, the facilities and the campus. Being 360 degrees, take a look around. Look up, look down, look behind you. What you see is our 1600 hectare farm, and in the distance you'll see the campus adjoining the farm, and that makes this a unique facility. Our history dates back over 120 years when this ground was part of the Wagga Experimental Farm. It's grown in size and it's grown in scale. Now we're running 450 cows, we're running over 2,000 sheep, we've got a continuous cropping program as well as all the wonderful facilities that I plan to show you through our tour today. But please, everywhere we go, remember, look up, look down, look around and look behind you. There is stuff happening everywhere. So please, jump on board. Let's have a great day. These commercial sheep yards are utilised by both our merino flock and our commercial prime lamb flock of sheep. They're attached to a four-stand shearing shed with raised board. We also have the bugle race leading up to dual drenching race and a Gallagher auto draft at the end. The auto draft allows us to draft sheep based on sex, weight gain, or average weight. It also utilises the electronic ear tags that all our sheep carry that give us lifetime data on the performance of those animals. It's also connected to our 32 pen feedlot facility that allows small scale research to occur in a range of areas, but primarily around nutrition. Within the yards, you'll learn a whole range of basic animal husbandry right through to more complex artificial breeding, natural breeding and nutrition management of sheep. So in this facility, one that's utilised largely through undergraduate study, you'll learn a whole range of aspects in the sheep industry. This 360 degree tour brings us down to the agriculture teaching plots, only a very short stroll from the lecture theatre. These plots are basically 1 hectare in size and give students the opportunity to get out of the lecture theatre into the paddock and look at how agriculture is done in some other ways that don't happen on the commercial farm. Take a look around. We've burnt some stubble. We're waiting for you to come and sow the crop. We've burnt the stubble to show other ways that farmers do things in industry and what that means for the crop and its development through the year. We've got pastures, we've got crops and a range of things here in the teaching plots. So have a look around. We look forward to seeing you soon. We welcome you now to the Charles Sturt University rhizolysimeter. We're about 2.5 metres underground in the rhizolysimeter, which is basically an underground laboratory. The rhizolysimeter has 72 cores, 2.5 metres deep and 760 millimetres in diameter. Those cores are full of soil of two different soil types found in the typical cropping zone across eastern Australia. In this rhizolysimeter, we're looking at the relationships between root development, soil and water dynamics, and then above ground, we can look at plant growth and development. Have a look around. I hope you enjoy what you see. You join me now at the Charles Sturt University Cattle Nutrition Facility. This nutrition facility has two sides to it. Behind you, if you pan around, you'll see the dairy beef project in action at the moment. That's a pen-based project where individual intake of animals isn't required, looking at weight gain in animals as a group rather than as individuals. Behind me, we have the GrowSafe chambers. This facility has the capacity to feed 64 animals, and that monitors individual intakes, particularly around food and water. And it does that using the electronic ear tags that are inserted in an animal's ear at a young age. That picks up the weight of the feed in the bunk before the animal eats, and then it records the weight of the feed after the animal's left. So we get really accurate information around how many kilos each animal's eating, and that's good for 64 head. This is a new facility. It was finished only in 2020. So please take a look around, the new facility in action, and here ready to go for the next intake of bulls that come in as a commercial facility as well. This is used more in the research line of the university rather than undergraduate teaching. So when we say research, that can be in an honours project, it can be a PhD or further research after you've graduated as postdoc or PhD level. So please take a look, look at the Frisian steers as part of the Dairy Beef Project and enjoy your visit. Cattle yards are a purpose-built facility. They're designed for teaching and for research, not necessarily for commercial cattle work. Have a look around and you'll see inside that we have six crushers designed for students to be hands-on in their learning. That's something key part of Charles Sturt University. The six crushers allow us to have six cows being handled at the same time, making your class size small and your groups with cows very, very small, down to individual students on one or two animals at a time. We have electronic weighing systems for easy capture of data, which is critical in research. Easy flow of cattle through the yards make this facility a really great one that Charles Sturt University has on offer. While you're here, have a look around. Remember, it's a 360 degree tour and you can see everything. This 360 degree view of our farm is located at Delura, which is a short distance from the campus, about 3 kilometres. The 360 degree tour right here now is looking at our continuous cropping program, which we try to run by industry best practice. Industry best practice is taught in the lecture theatre, and this is a really good opportunity for students, once they've heard it and seen the demonstrations in the lecture theatre, to come on farm and see it happening for real. The Delura farm is just under 400 hectares. It practices continuous cropping without any livestock in the system. The crop rotation up here involves canola, wheat, barley, and then faba beans. The faba beans using as a break crop to try and put some nitrogen back in the system to bring down the input cost that we've got. From one end of the paddock to the other is about 2.5 kilometres, and at a sowing rate, we get from one end to the other in about 15 minutes. So it is a large-scale demonstration of industry best practice on those four crops. We welcome you to this 360 degree view of one of many Charles Sturt University farm biodiversity plantings. Across the campus farm we have many plantings. This one along the Hooligans Creek is a riparian zone, excluding stock away from the creek, some tree planting that we did about 20 years ago. And in time, we've encouraged some more regeneration of natural species. That's bringing in bird life, insect life along these corridors, which not only enhances the environment, but is having beneficial impacts in our agricultural production. We have a range of plantings from shelter belts, erosion gullies, as well as this corridor along the creek. And we're trying to join all those up to get natural insect life and bird life throughout our entire farm. That's part of the undergraduate teaching in both agriculture and environmental sciences, just showing how the two different worlds can come together for natural good. Take a look around, listen to the bird life. It really is one of the most pleasant places on the farm. We continue our 360 degree tour of Charles Sturt University facilities here in the Irrigation Systems Laboratory. The Irrigation Systems Laboratory is looking at improving water efficiency through better water use and improving energy efficiencies in irrigation systems in Australian agriculture. Have a range of models that simulate different water uses and how that's impacted on infiltration rates and a range of other parameters in the Australian environment. We continue this out in the field with neutron probes in our olive grove and also in remote sensing in our annual cropping systems. This is going further then into industry, causing real practice change within industry in both annual and perennial crops grown in Australian agriculture. Our current 360 degree view is inside the Charles Sturt University glasshouses. In total, we have 4 glasshouses in common use, ranging PC1 and PC2. PC1 is more for student and undergraduate learning, such as this glasshouse. The PC2 is more for research where there's genetically modified organisms and pathogens. The PC1 glasshouse we're standing in We've got a canola plant here that will be used in undergraduate teaching. At the time of year we're filming, we don't have canola of this stage of its growth and production cycle, so it's important for the teaching that we can grow these plants out of season. So look around the glasshouse, plenty of plants, different varieties, different species, and most of that will go into undergraduate teaching with a little bit of research as well. Welcome to the 360 degree tour of the Charles Sturt Phytotron. The Phytotron is a unique laboratory here for plant growth. The difference between this and some of our other laboratories is that this is a precisely controlled environment. We control the environment in growth chambers, in that we control everything from carbon dioxide, water, temperature, light, and humidity. Have a look around, look in the growth chambers. I'm sure you'll find something to impress you. Welcome to the 360 degree tour of the National Life Science Hub here at Charles Sturt University. The Nash Building, as it's known, is a world-class teaching and research analytical chemistry lab, used largely in the teaching of plant, animal and soil science, environmental sciences, food production, nursing and midwifery, and also biomedical sciences. Students do their practical classes in here in the fields of biology, microbiology and chemistry. The building is also used extensively in research. Outcomes coming out of the Nash Building include improvements to food security, to animal production, agriculture production, pharmaceuticals, nutraceuticals, and also extensive environmental outcomes. Take a look around. I hope you enjoy your tour. Well, we start at the back gate and here we are standing at the front gate of the Wagga campus of Charles Sturt University. We've taken you across the farm, we've taken you through all the facilities. And I reckon you'd agree, it's hardly surprising 86% of our graduates have a full-time job within 4 months of employment. It's a big thanks from me for sticking around and watching this 360 degree tour. Love to see you on campus one day. In the meantime, safe travels, gotta fly.